Today, I'm going to highlight simple steps to build in Tinkercad and send diffusion. So let's get cracking. All right, so step one is going to be counterintuitive. Before we build in Tinkercad, I want you to open Fusion. Of course, that means you need to have installed Fusion and signed up. Once you complete the sign-in process, it bounces to a web browser to make sure you've got it, and then you can hit Open Product. It takes a moment for it to load, and then the reason that I always do this is because if we look right over here, there is a new update. I do not use Fusion all the time, so I like to make sure it's updated before we continue. I'm going to choose Update Now. If you look down here on the bottom, you can see that it is updating. I sped this all up with video editing, but it took about 2 minutes to complete. And if we look back at the job status right here, it's where we can restart Fusion. And of course, this time it's faster because we do not have to complete the sign-in again. Note it says we're all set. I will highlight one more important step. I find that if I go to Preferences, I find I am most comfortable if I go to the Pan, Zoom, Orbit shortcuts and set them to the Tinkercad mode. Of course, if you're coming from another tool, you can pick that as well. At this point, I'm going to close it. I'm going to close the old Autodesk, and I'm going to go to Tinkercad. If this is your first time seeing Tinkercad, you can get here by visiting Tinkercad.com. It is totally free. I always choose Sign In with Google. Today, we're going to hit Create Brand New 3D Design. I'm going to start by naming the file. We're going to call this Fusion Test. And let me give you a quick intro to Tinkercad. We generally build with basic shapes. You can bring out other shapes and you can cruise them on top. You can set them below, whatever you pick. Once your shape is in, you can combine them by selecting a hole in a solid. And when you do Control G, it cuts that shape in there. If we do Control Z, it does undo. It's that easy to build things in Tinkercad. Now, I also want to highlight that it saves automatically. If we go back here and just click on the workspace, there is our project. Now, I do want to highlight something else super cool while we're out here. Obviously, I'm done with the project at this point, but if you check out the properties, there is a version history. So it took me 26 versions to build this. You can see this is where we added the cube. And if we click here on version 2, that was what it looked like when we exported it. You can simply click restore and go back to your other project points that easily. Back to our original project, you'll notice this doesn't show the cylinder. That is because we did not group it. Let's hit Tinker this and go back to our real design. Now if I take those two and I regroup them with Control G, I'm going to back up really quickly one more time just so you can see now it shows the combined shape. That is how Tinkercad works. It always saves to the cloud and it's instant. All right, so currently this part's pretty small. I'm going to take it from 20 and I'm going to make it 80. So I'm going to shift stretch. I'm going to type the number 80 right here and it scales everything proportionally. Now, quite often users want to know how to round these edges or give them a fillet. Once again, the trick I prefer is send diffusion. Now you can fiddle around and do it with the meta fillet, but check this out. We're going to hit send to and we're going to just choose Autodesk Fusion. Of course, I've got the name Fusion Test. I do not need the design history. That would show how it was built. I'm not going to worry about that. I'm just going to click Send. Right here, I want to click Open in the local desktop. You can see here Tinkercad is thinking, and I just need to wait patiently. Bingo. It pops to this design where it mentions the design is opening, and then bam, here comes Autodesk Fusion with our part. How cool is that? I can right-click Orbit just like in Tinkercad, and then if I want to add a fillet, I'm going to hit F for fillet, and I'm going to click on this face right here, and then I'm going to type the number 0.5 and press Enter. Bang! It just did the fillets that easily. Let's check this one. Once again, the letter F for fillet. Let's see if this time we can type 1 and press Enter. Boom! It did that as well. You can, of course, try and do this with an entire shape. If I do Control-Z and Control-Z, I'm going to select everything real quick, and let's do F for fillet, and let's see what happens if we type 1 and press Enter. Bingo! Your entire shape has been filleted. How cool is that? At this point, if you want to bring this back to Tinkercad, you can click on Bodies, right-click, and choose Save as a Mesh. It shows Export instead of 3MF. I want STL Binary. I'm going to skip the rest of the settings and just hit OK. It asks where I want to put it. I'm going to call this Tank Test. And I'm going to save it in my 3D modeling folder and hit Save. Now, of course, we can bounce back to Tinkercad. I'm going to take this project and move it over here. And let's import what we just built. Choose File. Of course, it's in my 3D modeling folder. And there is the Tank Test. Bring it in as millimeters, keep the same measurements, and choose Import. And there, my friends, is our new rounded project. How cool is that? If we want to go back to that old size, the 40 that we had, we can simply Shift Stretch and type 40 and press Enter. How cool is that? All right, so those are my steps. This is what I've found works for me. Once again, having it all the way update, making sure you wait patiently. All of a sudden, it pops up and bingo, you can take your parts in. Now, you can have parts that are too complex in Tinkercad. They state in the docs that it's a more simpler project. All right, so here's the fun challenge I've got for your friends. I'm going to make a post on my channel, and in those posts, you guys can add images of your successful ones and your failures. Let's test the system and post some results. Friends, I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are three different levels of support starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. I also want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via Patreon. We are creeping up on 300 members. It has a fantastic messaging area. You can ask questions, gain skills, share designs. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, hype a video, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.